Toyota 22RE. This is how to remove your oil pan. This is my way of doing it, my experiences. This is my first time doing it on an IFS system. A couple reasons why you might need to remove your oil pan is you might have a leak, so you need to do your gasket. You might need to replace some bearings or whatever, or you might just need to get it replaced in general. Or if you're doing a timing chain, you have to remove it if you want to, and if you have stuff that has fallen into the oil pan. Let's get right into it. You do not need to jack the vehicle according to what I've done. You go ahead and remove the little splash guard. Splash guard right here. You go ahead and unbolt your pitman arm. No, sorry, this is your idler arm. Don't unbolt it right here at the cotter pin. Just remove these three bolts that's mounted onto your frame. I believe they are 17 mil. Go ahead and drop the whole steering system down. This is your steering damper. Go ahead and unbolt that. It connects right here. Go ahead and zip tie that too so it doesn't flop around. On your cross member, you have two bolts. One, two on each side. There are 17 mil. There's a bolt and then a nut on the other end. So you need a 17 mil wrench on the other end and then you can shoot it out. And then I went and removed the two mounts that holds the differential. Next thing you want to do is remove the two bolts that holds the differential to the frame. They are 19 mil and it goes right here and right here. They go vertical up. I couldn't get the oil pan out, so I decided to remove my front dry line from the dry line to the differential. I think you might not have to do that, but then I removed it anyway. But don't do that until you remove this bolt here as well. So this bolt that holds the differential, the front bolt, you need to remove that well, that as well too. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then all the idler arm. Remove all those first and then remove your front dry shaft if you still need to. Once you do that, you should be able to use your jack and put your jack on it before you unbolt everything, and then you can lower your jack and then you can kind of fight the differential and slide it out, and your oil pan should come out. It wasn't able to go from the back, so I was able to push the oil pan down and forward, and it came out from the forward. So that's what I end up doing. I haven't put it back on yet, but tomorrow I'll go ahead and clean the block nice and clean, and then I'll go ahead and test fit that on. I'll just go ahead and test fit it before I go in and reinstall it. I am also in the process of doing my timing chain, so I actually have to wait for all my parts to come in first before I will install my oil pan. But I hope this helps you guys. If you guys have a different method of doing it, you guys can leave it in the comment section below, share it with the community. And also, you don't need to remove all the radiator and stuff that I have up here. This is just for a different project that I'm doing. But if you're just dealing with the oil pan, that's what you will have to remove, all the stuff that I just point out. And again, guys, let me know what you guys think. And that's the quick look of it. Oh, also, you do have to remove the oil pickup tube. And it looks right here. There's four bolts. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there's four bolts that holds the oil pickup tube, and that's what they look like. And that's what the oil pickup tube looks like. So you got one bolt, two bolts, three, and four. So there's four bolts that holds the oil pickup tube. It's easier to just go ahead and remove that, and it bolts right on easily. So that's what you guys gotta do. Let me know if you guys have any comments, and I'll see you guys next time on the 22RE. Another thing I want to put in there is that you definitely want to go ahead and pressure wash it, degrease your oil pan when it's out, unless you're installing a new one. So make sure you pressure wash it, get out, get all of the old gasket off. And for the oil pan, I don't recommend using cork gasket or any kind of gasket. I recommend you guys use Permatex. Not the gray one, not ultra gray. For this oil pan, you have to use Permatex black silicone. The black silicone is rated for greasy stuff and high temperature stuff. So you can use the black silicone, not ultra gray RTV. Ultra gray RTV is great as well, but it's not made for this application. So make sure you get the black RTV, put a nice bead all around it and also around the bolt's hose, and you should not have any leak at all. Once you install this, make sure you let it cure for about 24 hours before you go and put oil into your engine. I like to do 24 hours, but if you're on a rush or on a time crunch, let it cure for at least 2-4 hours before you start driving it or putting any oil in it. But for me, I'm in no rush, so I'm gonna let it cure for 24 hours.